Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here, and in today's video, what we're doing is taking a look at an application called Biscuit. I will be diving into how I discovered it in a moment. I just want to say before we begin, this video is sponsored by the lovely folks at Woven. Woven is a powerful calendar application, and you can learn all about it a little later into this video. Just want to say a big thank you for them for sponsoring December 2019. Now, as you can imagine, there are obviously tons of apps trying to, make things a little bit easier during the day. And Biscuit is one of those applications. You can find it at eatbiscuit.com. I really love the URL for this one. The concept is really simple. It's a browser, as you can see in front of us. It's a browser for your applications. And, I don't know about you, but when you're on side of like Chrome, for example, you've got loads of different sort of tabs open. This is a bad example because at the moment I don't. But naturally, I know a lot of people who do suffer from sort of tab overload. There are a few extensions for this. But when it comes to actually, coordinating them into this sort of like app-like application where you can go down here and add an application, we'll show you in a moment, it becomes a lot easier because you can see everything there. And you can even bring together applications like Notion and Airtable. And that's exactly who I discovered it from. Chris Dancy in his video all about Airtable was actually using this application.
So I use something called Biscuit. Really small. I think the guy's one person shop, might be a lady, I'm not sure. But it's kind of like Station or any of these other kind of apps that kind of aggregate a bunch of web apps together. And what I did was I created a sidebar with the types of things I wanted to keep track of. So the very first section of my Biscuit is my health section.
He uses it not just to connect his Airtable, but he connects up his Notion as well. And on specific pages, which is really nice. So he actually has like, pinned areas that he can see on the side panel. And he also has his gyroscope information as well available. So it cuts out all of the, I guess, unnecessary information. If I go ahead and open it in full, it doesn't look half bad when you're using it. Very clean looking browser. Now, what's cool is up here, let's get started. You can see a sort of work separation. So what you can see is you've got a work area and how many tabs you've got under there and a personal area. So it does separate it. This is only on Mac from what I could find. And it is free, which is great. So you guys can sort of get started for free, which is handy. If you go down here and you press add new group, you could obviously add a new group that could be, for example, it could be like, social. So you could have a separate one for social and, one for professional, whatever, however you want to set up your groups. And all you do is go down to the bottom here and you press add application, and you can begin adding them to different areas. So they've got a good app directory, like you can connect up with like Airtable and Sana and Dropbox. So let's say I wanted to connect up with Quora, you can see there, and you can open it up and add this application. Now, what's cool is I did a little bit of digging because I was not really sure. Like, I guess once all these apps, it's like having a browser, privacy is pretty important. But they stated on their website that there's no tracking, and they state your life is yours, which I quite liked. And it says Biscuit does not track or analyze your use, nor will it send you anything. Your privacy is your right. So I thought that was pretty cool. And as you can see here, there's a way to actually get notified. So if there's a notification inside of the application, you can get a notification and you can see what that looks like. So this is what like Quora looks like. For me, like you can see all of the sort of, information, like if I want to go ahead and answer some questions, which I haven't done in a donkey's age, I can see all of the questions that potentially need answering. So it works exactly like a browser. And if I wanted to, I could go home here, back to the home page of Quora. I could refresh and I could go between the pages if I wanted to, back and forth. And I could also copy the text. Copy as text in the URL, that is, and whatever's in the clipboard. And you can even do a captured screenshot, and you can even share it to the Gmail that is in your work here. Now, one of the things that I guess is a pain when you're getting started with an application like this is actually re-signing into all of the applications that you already signed into on your existing browser. But I'm guessing this is much more of a distraction for experience. You can sort of like minimize how that looks. And I guess you're not changing between apps to some extent, which is pretty cool. So for example, if you had, you wanted your Evernote all accessible, your toggle, etc., you can have that all there. So let's go ahead and add Todoist. Okay, so there we go. Obviously, if I sign into my Todoist, like it all sort of pops up naturally, like it would in the web browser, which I find pretty handy. So a few comments regarding the application and how it compares to other applications like Shift. There's another application out there called Try Shift, and it can be found at tryshift.com. They're pretty similar. Obviously, Biscuit being totally free and developed sort of independently. Shift is more for team members, I'd say. It allows you to add team members, unified search, and is also available on all desktops like Linux, Windows, and Mac. But it does come at a price. I believe the annual price was $99.99 or $100 per year, which I think is pretty steep, but it depends on how much you use applications like this. And what's cool on this version, at least, you can naturally add the applications that you're already using, and there's no limit. Whereas on Shift, I believe there's some limitations to how many ads you can lift. But what's quite cool is that if you're, for example, emailing, like you can have that open up as your default email browser. Whereas this is quite handy just for really taking on the browser and bringing all your apps into one streamlined experience. So, guys, that was an overview of Biscuit. It can be found available in the description below. It's a free application. Thanks to Chris for introducing it to me. If I'm honest, I probably won't be using this as my go-to browser. Main reason is because I'm pretty comfortable with Chrome right now. I have no problems with it. So I guess I don't want to change and spend time moving base. But I do like the way this application, and if it is a huge issue for you, I think it's pretty suitable. Okay, guys, before we sign off, I wanted you to check out Woven. Woven is a powerful calendar application, and honestly, it's been one of the most impressive applications of 2019. So do check it out. Here's a little bit more information before we go. So guys, this month's sponsor is Woven. Now, Woven is a all-in-one calendar with powerful scheduling tools. Now, I discovered it back in November last year, and I've been using it for the last 3 months to manage my podcast meetings, festive plans, and much more. Now, Woven builds on existing calendar systems and gives you scheduling superpowers. Now, first off, Woven has plenty of scheduling tools baked in. Send scheduling links to book one-to-one meetings with clients. Create group polls to plan an after-work event. Or use smart templates to quickly time block your calendar. Secondly, the powerful Maps feature allows you to plot and plan your commutes, organize where your next meeting is, and get a sense of direction in your day, quite literally. My favorite feature has to be the scheduling tools. I've been using them for the podcast, arranging meetings, and also collaborations on the YouTube channel, and I've found it really easy to use. The design has to be shouted out too. Woven's attractive desktop app screams easy-to-use scheduling and helps you to get comfortable with your calendar. And Woven isn't just on desktop. You can get it on web and iOS too, with an Android app on the horizon. Now, I made a bold statement a few months ago. Woven is a new sunrise, and they're heading into a bright future. So try out this powerful calendar application today by visiting woven.com/keepproductive for more details. Thanks to Woven for sponsoring Keep Productive this month.